when this came up, it wasn't necessarily a reaction that this was negative news for us, but it was, we're here for a reason. We are on our right path. HWA presents us with an opportunity to bring community together. You know, I think as Indigenous peoples living in a colonial world, there are a lot of silos that we see out there. What I do see is that we bring this knowledge of not only land, but being stewards to it.
I want to thank the Creator Mother Earth that we get to speak today about our hemlock, our elders. And I thank the opportunity for them to provide their wisdom in our discussions this morning. Basically, for them to have a future where they get to see our children in the future in these woods together, having a great time together. That's our goal. One of my other goals here is to bring back a ceremony and what that actually means.
A simple walk in the forest and a simple hug to one of the hemlocks or to grandmother maple or an offering of tobacco, that simple gesture just puts people back in balance and healing that they've been searching for years being a part of this forest. I see the healing in them real time, and it's such a great thing to be a part of. It's another level of people just starting to see the world in different eyes. And they take that home and they take that in their communities, into their families, and it changes their whole world.
For Margaret and me, these two trees have always offered a threshold of no matter which way we're going through this way, going through this way. It's like, what are we leaving? What are we going toward?
So we can take a couple more minutes here and then maybe we can head back to the lodge. I can share some information back there about the pest. And we have Matt Miller, who's been involved in a lot of the HWA and hemlock work in the province, to answer any questions people have.
My hesitation was in the effects of the chemicals on different animals, right? I know it kills the bugs as well, different bugs, but doesn't have a lasting effect on it. It doesn't kill the birds and the squirrels and all that stuff around it. That gives us comfort in going forward. And because it's biodegradable too, and it only lasts about 5 to 7 years. And the alternative is letting the forest try and defend itself. That's not much success either. I don't really want to be in a position where I do nothing and we lose our hemlocks, because we're already struggling with that when it comes to ash, right? And how important ash is. And even with birch now, where that's even being affected by a bug. So it's be difficult for us to even teach canoe building. Yeah, I don't want to see that with hemlock.